This is the day that God has made. Let us rejoice and praise God with the singing of the hymn. Praise with joy the world's creator, voices united number 312. Let us stand.
Praise with joy the world's creator, God of justice, love, and peace, source and end of human life, God whose grace shall never cease.
That would be a good excuse to stay that way if not the one thing to appear.
In recognition of traditional territory, we, the members of Union United Church, have inhabited and continue to inhabit the land on which we worship. This is the traditional land of the indigenous peoples, and we are deeply grateful to be here and to ground ourselves in the land which has been a place of where people have lived for thousands of years.
Good morning, church. Welcome everyone to Union United Church's 11th Sunday after Pentecost, Emancipation Sunday-Communion. We are blessed and thankful to have all of you with us. A heartfelt welcome is extended to all visitors. Do we have anyone here that's visiting us for the first time? Okay, so I'd like to take this moment for inviting you to bring yourselves in. And so if you're willing to take a breath, relax your shoulders, soften your belly, and perhaps look to your right, look to your left, look in front, look behind, and take a moment to look the person in the eye as you welcome them here this morning to say good morning.
Peace be with you.
Excellent. You know, emancipation for me is about being seen, and for us to see each other, to take a moment to look at each other, to greet each other. So we're going now, I'm going to move to the announcements. Reverend Taylor's office hours. Reverend Taylor will be available for consultation meetings on Tuesdays and Fridays from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. Please feel free to contact her at 514-710-8731 or by email, minister@UnionUnitedChurchMTL, to schedule an appointment. And now we've got some upcoming events. Today we have the Emancipation Celebration. Today, Sunday 4th, from 1 p.m. to 7 p.m. at the Oscar Peterson Park at Chatham Road in Montreal. Activities will include key speakers, performing artists, wellness workshops, children's activities, foods, vendors, and more. The church, the park is not far from here, and I'm sure it would be a lovely, lovely event taking place afterwards.
And now I have a special announcement, and that is there will be a private wedding ceremony that will be taking place here at Union United Church on August the 8th. And I invite William Husband and Jennifer Woodley to please stand so the congregation will be able to see them. And we pray for God's ample blessings upon you as you're going to have your upcoming nuptials. Thank you.
Next on our announcements is Union United's 117th Anniversary Gala. Please note that the 117th celebration has been rescheduled to Saturday, August 10th, which will be next Saturday, starting at 5:30 p.m. All payments made prior to the original date will be honored and applied to the new event. If you would like to opt out, and I mean, who wants to do that, right? And receive a refund, please let Spence Telemac or Charlene Hunt know promptly to ensure timely processing. We apologize for any inconvenience this may have caused and look forward to seeing you all there. On August 16th, there is a gospel concert being organized by Gerard St. Gerard, hosted by Union United. It is free admission for all members of Union United Church, and it's $15 for the public. And although it's free for Union United members, if you would like to give an offering or a donation, that is always welcome. And that's taking place on August 16th, starting at 7 p.m. And it's going to be happening here at Union United. The Star Can Cultural Association invites you to join them for their Evening on the Town tour of Quebec City. The date is Saturday, August 17th. The cost is $85 for members and $95 for non-members. Meetup time and location, 7:15 at 1001 Dorchester Square. Departure time is 8 a.m. on the dot, and return to Montreal at 8 p.m. For more information, please call 514-998-7827 or 514-737-8229. The annual general meeting. The AGM will be taking place on Sunday, August 18th, immediately following the service in the Oliver Jones Reception Hall. If you are interested on sitting on any of the committees, please get in contact with the nomination committee at rickybarman7@gmail.com. It's a wonderful, wonderful opportunity to become a part of what is going on in the church. Next, we have the Marcus Garvey Salute on Saturday, August 24th from 1 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. at Vinay Park. Activities will include special guest speakers, children's activities, live performances, and educational entertainment. For more information, you can call 514-487-2790 or 514-846-0049. The email is uni@b334@outlook.com. Next, we have St. Genevieve United Church. They're inviting us to join them for their third annual picnic to be held on September 14th from 10:30 a.m. to 1 p.m. at Alexander Park, 14889 Oakwood in Pierrefonds. Come and enjoy a fun get-together with planned activities, music, some fellowship, games, and worship. And don't forget to bring your own chair and lunch. A special note that there will be some filming happening in the area on Notre Dame Street. And so for notice for residents that August 5th from 3 p.m. to 11 p.m., 3041 Notre Dame West, and all the side, it will be the street and sidewalk closures. People who have parking stickers number 70 will be relocated from August 4th from 5 p.m. through August 6th at 9 a.m. So if you want to maybe get in on a little film and walk by unexpectedly, you can maybe think about doing that. Just to let you know that the anniversary book and DVDs are always going to be on sale every Sunday downstairs in the Oliver Jones Hall. So if you'd like to get a copy of the book and or the DVD, you can always go right after church downstairs in the hall to receive a copy. We wanted to also let you know, happy anniversary to Kathy and Walter. On August 3rd, they celebrated the 56th wedding anniversary. Now that is something. And we also wanted to let you know that Moshe is now out of the hospital. So he is home now. So now we're gonna have our call to worship. I will read the first part and then you will respond for those parts that are in bold. God of all people, we come to worship you.
We come before you. Give you thanks and praise.
God of all people, we come to you as people whom you love.
We worship you today and always with our whole selves.
Everyone, let us worship God.
God of all people, we come acknowledging you in all your majesty and glory. We thank you that as Black people, we share with all humanity your divine grace and favor. Help us in our worship to lift to you all creation in its beauty and splendor. Help us in our worship to remember the struggles and pain of our ancestors. Help us to journey with pride, strengthened by those whose struggles and sacrifice have paved the way of liberty for us. Help us in our reflections to recommit to seeking justice and liberty for ourselves and all who are devalued, exploited, and oppressed. To you be all honor and glory today and always. Amen.
And as we have the lighting of the Christ candle, as we light this candle, this Christ candle, we light a symbol of the presence of Jesus with us individually and as a community of faith. And now you'll say with me, as we light this candle, we acknowledge it as a guiding us
to Jesus' vision of the kingdom of God.
The kingdom of God that is our call and framework to our discipleship. And now the candle is lit.
The Spirit of the Lord.
is that absolute special time where we have story time with Reverend Taylor.
I'll have the children in front. How are you today? Good to see you, as always. It's always a special day when I see, you know, the children in the congregation, because you're special to all of us. We are a community. Okay, so today, do you know what today is? What's special today? It's called Emancipation Sunday. You know what the word means, emancipation? It means freedom. Can you tell me, what is freedom to you? Yes? You don't have to listen to, yeah, it all depends. Now, if your parents have things to tell you, that would be different, but yes. But no, you're not wrong with that. It's just that, yes, we want to be able to have positive things coming towards us, you know? Like being said to us. And sometimes people can say things that are not nice, you know, who we are as a people, you know, by the way we dress, the way we look, things like that. So, and what kind of things do you do when you're free? Like, what kind of things do you do as children? Play with your best friend? You can draw, yes. Ah, you could run around in circles. We've all done that as well. Anything else? Yeah, and you're with your families, right? Because that's really important. So a long time ago, we had children just like yourselves taken from their homes in Africa. They were taken. They were placed on ships. They were sent to other countries. They did not know the language. So they were stripped. As I would say, stripped of their language, meaning that their language was taken away. So whatever languages that were spoken in different areas of Africa were not allowed to be said. Children were not allowed to go to school. Children did not know how to read and write. They weren't taught. Children had to work very hard with their with other people too, who came from the same countries that they came from, the continent of Africa, to work very hard in fields and different doing things such as picking cotton. You ever seen cotton fields? Sometime I'll have to show you a photo of that. But it's all different types of fields. Okay, they were called plantation fields. And the thing is that with that, also that families were taken apart. So children were removed from their parents, and parents also too were separated. So you didn't have your whole family with you, and it was very hard. And what was hard is that, you know, you just didn't understand what was happening at the time. But then something came, and it's called the Abolition of Slavery Act. Okay, that came August 1st, 1834. And the thing is that with that, children like yourself, 6 years and up, were able to be free, but some of them still stayed on the land. So what we are honoring today is the freedom. What we're focusing on is freedom. Freedom that you can do what you would like to do as children. You can play together. You can have your family with you, that you can eat meals. When this freedom came, families sought out for each other. They wanted to know where their family was, and that's so important. Because even today, well, we have ancestry.com, right? Or CA, and we try to connect with family because it's for us to know what's called our heritage, where we came from, the languages that we spoke, and how we can connect with one another as a family. Here at Union United Church is rich in history. Myself, as your minister, will be giving you a lot of information about how we are to be as a community. One of the oldest Black churches here in Quebec. How we're supposed to love each other, how we're supposed to help each other. One of you is sad, then the other one will ask, well, why? And just that gives comfort. These are things that did not happen during slavery. These are things that were taught afterwards. And some people had to try and be with others to learn how to live as community again, as they did in Africa. So this is just a little snippet of what I have for today, because there's so much information, but as time goes on, you'll be able to learn more about our culture. So today is a celebration, and we're celebrating freedom, a physical freedom, and also mental freedom. That's my story for you, and we're going to pray. God, we give you thanks for our children, that they can learn from us our heritage, that they can also celebrate with us the freedom, so that they know that they within themselves are free. They are valued, they are loved, not only by us, but we know that you are there present with them. So in this learning, we pray that as they learn from us, that they can also show each other how they're supposed to act towards each other and help them in their stages of growth as they learn more about who we are as a people. Amen.
And now we'll have the children's hymn, May the God of Hope Go With Us. That's Voices United 424. Be seated. And now we have a wonderful, wonderful opportunity to hear Sister Chantal Guru Sherwood with a wonderful music ministry. Thank you. Good morning, church.
Good morning.
So today I'll be singing I Worship You, originally done by Mary Mary.
You came and found me. You left your throne thinking about me. You bled and died to show me mercy. You gave your all because you saw my need. I was empty, but you came and filled me. I was blinded, but you helped me to see. I was broken, you made me whole again. I felt like nothing, but you gave me confidence. And I'm filled with so much gratitude. Words are not enough to explain the magnitude, passion of my love. Oh, you took everything I was, made me what I am. And with all I am, I worship you. You took everything I was, made me what I am. And with all I am, I worship you. You were alive when I was dying. You were strength when I was crying. And you were right and I was so wrong. A melody when I had no song. And I'm filled with so much gratitude that words are not enough to explain the magnitude, the passion of my love. Oh, you took everything I was, made me what I am. And with all I am, I worship you. You took everything I was, you made me what I am. And with all I am, I worship you. Oh, 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 you took everything I was. Oh, you did. I worship you, Lord. Took everything I was. Oh, you changed me, Lord. I worship you.
We have now the sacrament of Holy Communion.
Thank you.
One of the traditions of at Union United Church is actually having the elements of the communion table, and then it'll be distributed to the congregation. And we did that years ago, and then because of COVID, we had to make some changes. So now we are starting back the tradition. And for Emancipation Sunday, I figured it would be the best time to have it. So we will have now the communion hymn. I will ask everyone to please stand if you're able. Let us talents and tongues employ. We will be singing one verse, Voices United, number 468, verse 3. Jesus calls us in, sends us out, bearing fruit in a world of doubt, gives us love to tell, bread to share, God Emmanuel everywhere. Jesus lives again, earth can breathe again, pass the word around, love's about. Jesus lives again, earth can breathe again, pass the word around, love's about. I'll just ask for then just the top of to be removed, please. Okay, thank you. The sacrament of communion, you may be seated, thank you. The sacrament of communion is an open invitation to everyone seeking a personal relationship with God. And as we partake of communion, we're united as a community of faith. We're reminded that Jesus Christ was resurrected to give us hope and to give us strength and endurance in our journey of faith. We will now have the blessing of the elements. Let us pray. Lord, as we take this bread and drink this cup, we ask for your blessings. Remember that you are the bread of life. You feed our souls, you nourish our hearts, and you give us sustenance. Lord, as we drink from this cup, remember that you are the giver of life. You are forgiveness. You bring deep peace to our soul, and your love flows within us as we remember your crucifixion and that you are raised to life by God. We give you thanks as we partake of Holy Communion. And now it will be distributed. And I ask you to please, you can open the top part, which is the wafer. And then when we're ready, we're going to take the wafer together. And then we're going to have the juice. Distribute. everyone have? Okay. We have the call to give thanks. Christ is risen. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
For the prayers of thanksgiving, let us say together, loving God, you made this wonderful world for us to enjoy. You gave us Jesus to be your friend and to bring us closer to you. He died on a cross, but you brought him to life, to live with us forever. You send us your Spirit and bring us to this table so that we can share your love. For all your goodness, we give you thanks, and all together we give you praise. We have the song of creation, Holy, Holy, Holy God. Please say with me, power of life and love. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. On the eve of his betrayal, Jesus renewed God's covenant promise. Jesus said, I am the bread of life. And he took the bread he offered to God, asking for blessings. And then he said, take and eat. This is a symbol of me. And do this in remembrance of me. Then at the close of the meal, Jesus poured the cup of blessing, and he also asked God to bless it. Then he said to those around him, this is the cup of the new covenant, and whenever you drink of it, it is in remembrance of me. We have the sharing of the bread and the cup. Jesus Christ is the bread of life. And what we'll do, you have your cup. We'll just have the wafer that's on top. Jesus Christ, the bread of life, we take and we eat. This is a cup of blessing for all of us. We will take and drink, and we will say, thanks be to God. And let us come together as we have the prayer after communion. God, we give thanks that the bread broken brings wholeness, that the wine poured out of replenishes, that time spent with the risen Christ and one another is gift and grace. Amen.
Just before we start the scripture readings, we have two little announcements to make. Brother Charles Clarkson, who was in hospital, is here today. And so we want to give thanks to that. And
also we have Pamela Walcott, who's here today as well. We're passing with her father.
And Mervyn Weeks, who had surgery, is also here with us today. Mervyn McLeod, I should say, Mervyn McLeod. Are there any birthdays? As we are in the month of August now, is anyone celebrating birthday? Ah, we have a few. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Yay! We'll be celebrating you all month. And now for our scripture readings. The first scripture reading will be by Sister Ingrid Dixon.
Exodus 16, 2-4. In the desert, the whole community grumbled against Moses and Aaron. The Israelites said to them, "If only we had died by the Lord's hand in Egypt. There we sat around pots of meat and ate all the food we wanted. But you have brought us out into this desert to starve this entire assembly to death." Then the Lord said to Moses, "I will rain down bread from heaven for you. The people are to go out each day and gather enough for that day. In this way, I will test them and see whether they will follow my instructions." This is the word of God.
And now, if you're willing to stand.
To the Son and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be.
Be seated. Our second scripture reading will be done by Sister Debbie Hunt.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Romans 12, verse 1-8. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in the view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is true and proper worship. Do not conform to your pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, His good and pleasing, perfect will. For by the grace given to me, I say to everyone, do not think of yourself more highly than you ought to, but rather think of yourself with sober judgment, in accordance with the faith God has distributed to you. For just as each of us has a body with many members, and these members do not have the same function, so in Christ we, though many, form one body, and for each member belongs to all of us, to others. We have different gifts according to the grace given to each of us. If your gift is prophesizing, then prophecy in accordance with your faith. If it is serving, then serve. If it is teaching, then teach. If it is to encourage, then encouragement. If it is given, then generously. It is to lead, do it diligently. It is to show mercy, and do it cheerfully. This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise.
And now, if you're willing and able to rise for the sermon hymn, Healer of Our Every, number 3, Voices United, number 619.
Be seated. Following prayer is by Joanne Carlson Brown, ministrymatters.com. Let us pray. We come to hear your voice calling us to be and do what you have called us to be and do, O God. Let this time of worship quiet our fears, soothe our bruised souls, and energize us for ministry in and with your beloved world. Let faith abide. Let hope abide. Let love abide. Here in this sanctuary, here in our community, here in our world, most of all, here in us. Amen. Today we are celebrating Emancipation Sunday to commemorate the day in 1834 in which the Slavery Abolition Act of 1833 came into effect for many British colonies, liberating enslaved children under the age of 6. We honor this day each year, the first Sunday of August, as a reminder of our continued work in advocacy so that all human beings will be valued as persons. During the transatlantic slave trade, the African person was dehumanized, robbed of dignity, respect, and empathy. The African person was reduced as chattel that was sold. The effects from slavery created the mind of bondage that led a person to have a mindset of putting oneself down in the community. Statements such as also, I'm better than the other due to circumstances in life that has placed me in a better position of recognition and financial bearing, while others in the community are suffering. For the ones who think that they have better standing in life and that they are superior, many people do not reach that glass ceiling as the dominant group. We're reminded that suffering came to the slaves who worked in the households and to those who worked in the fields. And we are aware that to put ourselves down is to put down all of our people. The Slavery Abolition Act of 1833, when the ones who are older than 6 years old had to work from 4 to 6 years, they were retained as apprentices. As well, there was compensation to the slave owners whose slaves were deemed free. Due to the Slavery Abolition Act, more than 800,000 African slaves and descendants were liberated in areas of the Caribbean, Africa, South America, and Canada. Thousands of African Americans came to Canada seeking a better life, and they would experience the harsh reality of racism in Canada. When we think of what we went through as a people, in Exodus, Moses led his people, the Israelites, to freedom from Egyptian slavery under Pharaoh. It was a feat that had seemed impossible. However, Moses relied on his faith in God of love to give him the stamina to liberate his people physically and emotionally as he led them to unknown territory that was harsh. We're shown in scripture how the Israelites responded to Moses and his brother Aaron. After traveling through the desert without water, not having food to eat, walking in rough and unfamiliar terrain, the Israelites said to them, if only we had died by the Lord's hand in Egypt. There we sat around pots of meat and ate all the food that we wanted. But you have brought us out into this desert to starve this entire assembly to death. The Israelites did not recognize that in their minds was still bondage. They could not see beyond their circumstances. However, Moses had the stamina to assist his people to resist self-ridicule of not being of worth, that is dehumanizing the self and their community. Similarly, centuries later, we would have a young woman called Harriet Tubman, would be known as Moses. The feat that she accomplished during her lifetime was not small in any scale. It would have been conceived as impossible to free slaves through the Underground Railroad that were secret routes and safe houses leading to Canada. In unknown territory, Harriet Tubman worked with white abolitionists and free blacks, African Americans, and would face similar challenges as the biblical Moses did with his people whose minds were still in bondage. On May 28th to May 29th, this year, I attended the Black Clergy Network Gathering at Emmanuel College in Toronto. There was a speaker who spoke about resistance is resilience. And as I was thinking about today and what I have in mind to say, I reflected on the information received that I will share with you. During the presentation, the speaker spoke about resilience as how we recover from trauma and difficulty. Resilience is a necessary response to lower the impact of systemic racism. And it's important to redefine resilience as we challenge structures of power and inequalities. Also to challenge the voices that define what emotions that are a positive or successful traits and strategies for coping during traumatic times. In society, resistance and differences are a threat to the status quo. The status quo is what's keeping people down in life that they'll have no hope. Racism is systemic within the structures in society, whether it's in the churches, politics, medical fields, social, economic structures, just to name a few. The voices of Black and racialized people are often overlooked. Now, some insights from the meeting and from our breakout groups were that resistance is formulated to keep our identity and thrive. And when we do this, we have an emancipated mind. We are to empower our Black communities within the United Church of Canada for the present and the future by creating our framework within our own people. We are to give space to people to express their feelings of racism by giving them a platform to share our knowledge with them. There is a cost to speaking our truth, but it has to be done. Speak our truth and continue to educate the dominant church on power and privilege. Support Afro communities and remember that resistance is being faithful to the word that is the prophetic word of God. So how can the church be resilient? There are examples that was given to us at the time about a child who comes to you. She's angry. And the question to ask her is, are you hurt? And the child cries and said that she feels isolated. But where is the trauma coming from? So the speaker said that we're surviving what our grandparents have been going through and generations before. The way to resist power is by claiming our faith and our identity of whom we are as a people and a community, because whatever we are experiencing has an impact on our families. To have an emancipated mind is to look at oneself, find what we may like, what we see in the mirror, or words that come out of our mouths that are harsh, degrading, and are expressions that comes from a mind of bondage. There must be change. It is important for us to reinvent our lives to have an emancipated mind. In her reflection entitled The Emancipated Mind, Remember, Reflect, Refocus, she mentions the importance of transforming the hearts and minds of people. The Reverend Sadeki Little Forbes, minister of Sharon Hope United Church in Sharon, Ontario, shared some points. And some of it I paraphrase. Acknowledge that God is merciful and do the right thing to honor God. Have a renewed outlook on the way the world should work that shows God's goodness, that gives us joy. Remember that everyone is free and don't think that you are above others. Let each person have a chance to know what their gifts are. Tell them what kind of gifts that they have that they can contribute to the community, and therefore they'll be expressing themselves. Display love and respect to people who are different. Be enthusiastic about serving others. Lift each other up. Be forgiving and also be faithful in prayer. Be hospitable and have joy with people who are happy. Mourn with those who are experiencing losses in their life. Have harmony with people and be humble so that you can interact with people who are down-spirited. And most of all, to have integrity and be at peace with people. When we incorporate these steps in our lives, we can be transformed. As well, the world can change based on how we interact with each other and with the social systems that will lead us to have emancipated minds. The examples of Moses in the scripture and Harriet Tubman shows us that God provides for us by giving us nourishment in our minds. The manna that the bread came from heaven and the quail that Israelites received from God shows God's provision for us, that God supplies our needs in new ways while we're in unfamiliar territory and when we do not know what the future holds for us. It's for us not to have our minds cluttered with negative thoughts of self-devaluation that damages our emotional state and those around us. When we worship God in prayer, God will make a way for us to have emancipated mind filled with new possibilities of hope of a better future that can be achieved. It's like the story that I told the children, learning more about our heritage and how we go forward together. Similarly, the Apostle Paul mentioned in his letter to the members of the church in Rome under the oppressive Roman Empire that they were supposed to live their lives not in the ideology of Roman beliefs, but focus on what God has done during Jesus' ministry, death and resurrection, that gives a person new opportunities of wellness. The Apostle Paul emphasized that what we're supposed to give to each other would be no less than what God has given us. How are we moving forward with an emancipated mind? The United Church of Canada has anti-racism policies, and they have Adele Halliday, who is the anti-racism lead, and there is 40 days of engagement of anti-racism, which is a time of learning, reflection, and action. And they also have stories that are shared, people's experiences of what they've gone through and how they were able to overcome adversity. So the message today is to inspire us in our faith in God through Christ, who enlightens us as to what opportunities await us that we can build up as a people. And it's for us not to let the opportunity slip away of what we can do for each other so that we all will have emancipated minds. God wants us to make most of our lives with the gifts that God has given us. As the African proverb says, it takes a village to raise a child, as we're all God's children wanting security and compassionate love. Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Taylor. You know, I loved listening to what she was saying, and what came to me, what I heard as I was listening, was that resilience in ourselves, that resilience within our mind, the resilience of how we think to ourselves and then how we speak to others. And so in that reframing our thoughts so that we can become emancipated within ourselves and then as a community. So thank you, Reverend Taylor.
Thank you.
And now we're blessed again to have another music ministry from Chantel Guru Sherwood.
Just good morning. Morning, church. God is good.
All the time.
My goodness. Actually, come over here, Chantel. It's good to see Blair back in church. Blair's going to sing with Chantel. They're going to sing something special. If you don't know Christ, you need to know Christ. He will supply all of your needs. So I want to prepare the church before you sing this song. Ask him to come into your heart right now. Close your eyes. Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus was the best thing I ever, ever done. In his arms, I feel protected. In his arms, never disconnected. In his arms, I feel protected. There's no place I'd rather be. Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus was the best thing I've ever done. Open your heart right now to receive this powerful message by Chantel and Blair.
Thank you.
Order my steps in your word, dear Lord. Lead me, guide me every day. Send your anointing, Father, I pray. Order my steps in your word. Please order my steps in your word. My words edify, let the words of my mouth be acceptable in thy sight. Take charge of my thought both day and night. Order my steps in your word. Please order my steps in your word. Order my steps in your word. Dear Lord, lead me, guide me every day. Send your anointing, Father, I pray. Order my steps in your word. Please order my steps in your word. Order my steps in your word. Praise your name.
feet in your word. Wash my heart in your word. Show me how to walk in your word. Show me how to talk in your word. When I need a brand new song to sing, show me how to let your praises ring in your word, in your word. Oh, what are my steps in your word? Please order my steps in your word.
That was amazing. That was wonderful. Thank you so much. And now we have the invitation for offering that will be collected at this moment. And so if we'd like the ushers to come down. I loved what the worship leader said last week, so I'm going to repeat or paraphrase what she says. You know, offering is not just about the money. Consider if you're willing and ready to offer your time, your expertise, your connections, as a way to help ensure that Union United will remain a pillar of this community for another 117 years.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. For he is worthy, worthy. For he is good. Yes, he is good. For he is worthy, worthy. For he is good. Yes, he is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. For he is worthy, worthy. For he is good. Yes, he is good. For he is worthy, worthy. For he is good. Yes, he is good. Oh, give thanks. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord. For he is good. Yes, he is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. For he is worthy, worthy. For he is good. Yes, he is good. For he is worthy. Yes, he is worthy. For he is good. Yes, he is good. Let's sing one more time. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Yes, he is good. For he is worthy. Yes, worthy. For he is good. Yes, he is good. For he is worthy, worthy. For he is good. Yes, he is good.
And now we have another offering for the benevolent one.
The doxology.
Oh, the doxology.
Oh, wait, just a second. Yes.
Yes.
We're just going to hear the prayer.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Creator, in thankfulness to you and all that you continue to do, we offer you these gifts to continue your work here in this place. Receive not only our gifts of money, but also receive us, the givers. You have created all of us in love, and with love, you continue to be with us. Use these gifts and ourselves to proclaim the dignity of all persons and the love that you have for us all. Amen.
And now we have another offering, the second offering for the Benevolent Fund. Now, often we say, dig a little deeper. Today, I want you to maybe shake those pockets, right? Turn upside down, see what falls out, right? As we offer once again for the Benevolent Fund to ensure the church remains here. The doxology. The doxology now.
Please stand.
Please stand.
God, we give you thanks for this day. We ask for your blessing on this offering for the Benevolent Fund. It'll go to advocacy, oh God, that there'll be justice for all people. We pray this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Now we have the prayers of the people. Let us pray. God of all people, we come before you with our joy, our pain, our hope, and our gratitude. We come before you to celebrate the gift of our beauty as Black people, a beauty not only reflected in our skin, but also in our hearts. Thank you, Creator, for reminding us of your love for all people. We commit to living in love in the face of aggression, oppression, prejudice, and hate. We pray for your kindred all over the world, for whom emancipation is not reflected in the reality, but remains a distant dream. We pray, O God, that you will grant healing in every place of pain and suffering. Our prayers are extended to Moshe and all of those who are also mourning. We also extend our prayers to those who are experiencing persistent injustice and inequity, and has led to broken spirits and loss of hope. We pray for peace in a world where there's so much conflict, division, and hate. Help those who have been victims of persistent and systemic inequality, injustice, and violence to find healing, freedom, and restoration. We pray for those who continue the fight to make emancipation more than just a vision, but a practical reality for millions of people around the world. Amen.
And now I'd like to invite you, if you can, if you're able, to stand as we sing the Lord's Prayer. I just want to, you may all be seated. Just want to let you know, there is so much that goes on behind the scenes in order to bring together this service for everyone. And so at this time, you know, to make sure that it flows effortlessly for us to enjoy. And so, of course, there are always people who are outside of what we can see to make things happen. And so at this time, I'd just like to thank Carol Boyce for continuing to prepare the bulletin, Wendy Sparks for doing it from afar, Kimball Sherwood for all of the electronics and for the songs that he sang today, Sister Shannon for operating the scenes, Brother Samuel for handling the Zoom video, Sister Nancy for playing the organ, Sister Chantel for the music ministry. Our greeters, John and Victor. Of course, the one person who is always here opening the doors for us bright and early every Sunday. You know. To our communion and worship team of Debbie, Beverly, Victor, and John. The ushers for the communion, for the offerings, and of course, for Reverend Taylor for her sermon for today. And last and not least, of course, a great thank you to all of you for choosing to come to be here today, both in person and on Zoom. It's always so wonderful to see the church filled with people here to engage each other. So thank you.
Mm-hmm. Just wanted to mention something, and it's just so wonderful to have our communion the way how we had it before. Carol and Ingrid also helping, and everybody else, and thank you for all of your support since I've come. Thank you so much.
And now we have our closing hymn. If you would stand for Take Up His Song, number 213.
We'll now have the benediction and commissioning. May God bless you and keep you. May God's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May God look upon you with kindness and give you peace. And all of us will say, let us go to our work and into our relationships, stimulated by hope, strengthened by faith, directed by love, to play our part in the liberation of all people, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.